Hey, what's up guys? This is Tyler Reckart. You know me as SWAT GFX or Rex. You can call me anything you'd like of that manner. And welcome back to another screencast tutorial. And before I start the new tutorial, I'd like to show you, this is my new brand identity, my new logo that I've created for myself. This will be my brand identity for a while. And so let's get into the tutorial. Let me exit out of that, and exit out of that. Alright, but first thing I'd like to say is that the logo is not any sort of font. It is a custom shape done with the pen tool in Adobe Illustrator. I just want to clear that up right now, because I know if I didn't clear that up, I would have people asking for the font. So, anyway, now into the tutorial. So in today's tutorial, we'll be covering histograms. So let's just open up Adobe Photoshop, and I'm just going to open up my desktop wallpaper because a histogram is associated with pictures most of the time. So let me just open that real quick. Okay. All right, so what is a histogram? Well, we'll find out right here. So we're gonna go to layer, image, adjustments, and levels. And here's where we get our histogram. This controls the brightness, contrast, pretty much all of the ratios within our photograph. So this middle slider basically controls the equilibrium of the photo. One up here controls the threshold, and this controls the brightness. And if you have the brightness all the way over to the left, it will be the brightest possible, and the threshold will obviously bring up the threshold, and that is hurting my eyes. So we won't do that. You've probably seen this before, like if you've taken a photo on a really nice, expensive camera, they'll sometimes have these histograms that allow you to mess around with the photo. So as you can see, I'm moving the middle slider, and this is controlling the overall, saturation or contrast or brightness of the photo. This is like the overall switch. Alright, so you can always, there's in your channel preset, there's something called RGB, which is basically, when a photo is taken, there's three levels of light. There's red, green, and blue. Those combine, give off an image spectrum, which produce different sorts of colors. The most common red, green, blue combination is white. But if we just leave it to these standards, you get certain colors. Like if we take out the red, you just get the green and blue. And if we oversaturate the red, we lose most of our green and blue. So let's take out the red. Let's go to the green channel, take out the green, and we're just left with the blue. Now we can oversaturate it as well. Let's just go to RGB. Actually, I have to put the red back up to its normal. Alright, and with the histogram, we have custom and default. You can always make presets for your photographs to make them work better. I will open up a new photo, and let's go to... And this one's good. Alright, oops. Sorry about that. So, if we go ahead and mess with the threshold or the histogram, okay, the levels of the photo, let's make it a little bit darker. Kind of get it a little bit saturated. Bring up the threshold. Alright, so that was a real quick adjustment, and that this, you can go and do a lot more complex adjustments that take a lot longer and end up with a lot better results. Basically, all I did was do an advanced contrast change, but if you want to change the contrast real easy, just go to Image, Adjustments, Brightness, and Contrast. Now that I've taught you about histograms, that's all for this short tutorial. So, thanks for watching. Please rate, comment, subscribe.